That'll be fine. Alright. And we'll call him Batman. Easy. Alright. There he is!
Hello, Kira Cub. Hello, everyone. Thanks for the raid. No, I'm just kidding. Burr raid. I'm just starting on something, so you're seeing me just in the beginnings of stuff. Did I freeze? Yeah, I'm just focused. I gotta turn the mic off too. So sorry for that. But I'll type. Really? Wrong one. I did the wrong one.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hey, Bearded, how you doing? You caught me just in time. I'm actually going to close down pretty soon, but not right now. Not this second, but pretty soon. So just giving you fair warning. I saw you streaming earlier. What were you doing? Like, what was your stream tonight? Oh, thank you, sir. This guy's hard because he's got such ornate armor. This is still kind of rough. Well, it's a very rough sketch. Oh, yeah, yeah. I forget. You're East Coast, right? Oh, new comic idea. That's cool. Hold on just a sec. I'll be right back. West Coast, you're going to bed early. You might work early, huh? I know, but I stay up so late all the time that at this time, this is like my prime time. I get exhausted during the middle of the day and then get my second wind and then I'm like good to go. I can go to 4 o'clock no problem. But today I'm not gonna do that. I got some work I gotta do fairly early in the morning, so I'm gonna force myself to go to sleep. So you all set for tomorrow? Yeah, I think it'll be fun. Yeah, I'm waffling bad. Part of me is like, oh man, Paladin would be kind of cool. But I think my only problem is gnomes are so damn small. I like the idea of the rogue character, and I like the idea of the arcane trickster. I just don't like itty bitty gnomes. So I don't know. But yet my character in my head can only be a gnome. So my character concept has to be a gnome, because I was looking at other characters and I'm like, well, if I want to be a half elf, it doesn't fit. So yeah, I know. I saw that. They do get some phenomenal extra attributes, so I mean they get some good stuff. That gnome cunning, that's going to come in handy. Yeah, I'm not saying they're a bad character. I just wish they were a bit taller. I wish they were like a 5 foot character instead of this 3.5 feet. But I'll make do. Maybe I'll just make him a stocky gnome so that he's got a little bit more mass to him. But it'd be cool. I've already got some ideas. I've got my... When I'm third level, I get to have some spells. And I already know I'm going to have this level. He's going to be a gunslinger, basically. But he's just going to have this tool to... Just for show, to be honest. But to cast his cantrips. Yeah. Yeah, different heights are always good. And I didn't want to be... I mean, Monk is sounding fun. I think you're going to have a lot of fun. Paladin sounded like a lot of fun. But I didn't want to be anything that anyone else was. Just so that we do have that variety and kind of mix things up. It'll be fun. Oh, the gunslinger part? Yeah. It's actually a character in the comic book that I was going to do. So I'm kind of like, you know what? I'm going to use him for this game. And it's going to be a gnome. My comic book character, the gnome's more of an alchemist. Alchemist slash inventor. But one of his inventions was going to be this gun. And the original idea was the gun basically is just a holder for a wand. And he was going to put in like a wand of magic missiles. And it was going to have a mechanical trigger instead of a somatic component. But it basically does the same thing as the wand does. But I want to do that like right off the bat. So I was looking at the rules and stuff. I go, how can I do this without, one, customizing? Because I'm not looking to make a house rule or anything like that. And I'm like, oh man, they get to cast these cantrips at will every round. And he's got this firebolt cantrip that's, you know, at low level, this thing's tough. I'm like, all right, that's what I'll do. I'll just make the gun, and he gets to cast the cantrip anyway, so it's just sort of like a focus. He'll cast his cantrip out the barrel of the gun. And that way I get my little character concept without changing anything. Yeah, I couldn't believe it. 1 to 10 at 120 feet for first level at will. I'm like, holy crap. I'm totally going to play a sniper. So basically that's what it is. I mean, I was originally thinking I would have a human rogue, and he'd be a little bit on the scrappy side, but after reading up on gnome and everything, and plus their size and learning that you can do sneak attack at range, holy crap, that's what I'm going to be doing. So definitely a sniper hiding in the shadows. And I get some illusion and enchantment spells and a couple other random things. Plus I'll be able to use wands and stuff. I know, right? Like once you get started, it's like you can't stop. I don't have time to do all this stuff, but it's so much fun. The other thing I was thinking for a monk, because they get staff, right? Quarter staff. I think that's the best monk weapon you can have. And I was like, how can I use a 3-section staff? And I was like, you know what? That'd be cool because a quarter staff, you know, has a little bit of reach. But then if you're fighting in tight quarters, if it's a 3-section staff, then you break it down and you get to use that in tighter quarters. Yep. Yeah, but a monk is there to just be cool. I mean, it's a great fighter, in my opinion. It may not be the highest damage dealer, but you're definitely going to be dealing a lot of damage. Plus, you got all that speed, all those defenses as you level up. You're going to be practically immune to everything. So there's a lot. And Flurry of Blows is going to be fantastic. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. Yeah, if it's a true item that's not in the game, I totally agree, crafted in the game. I figure I could get away with my gun, because all it's going to be is a wood carving. Because it's not like a magic item. It's just doing what I could already do. Later on, it actually would be cool if I could make it a mechanical component, and it's a magic item of some sort that, you know, you shoot it and when it triggers, it shoots the force bolt or something. I'm not much of a crafter. I'll just pay. Although, come on, I'm a gnome. I should be able to do it. I'll do it in the off time. You In fact, I'll be your... I have to remember, I'm not a wizard gnome. I'm a rogue gnome. So I'm not going to be that much of an inventor. Not like the wizards. Yep. Yep, totally agree. I think the one thing I like about the monk too is that they're so... they get to travel so light. And they'll hold their own. In just about any situation, they'll hold their own. I think they're a great class. They're one of my favorites. Like I've said many times, monk and paladin tend to be my two favorite classes. Paladins are freaking epic in 5e. Holy crap. I was reading them, I'm like, man, they're almost overpowered. They're awesome. Yeah, I'll tinker a little bit, but I'm not going to be an inventor. You know, I think, you know, my gun might be my only invention. And it may not even be my invention. Maybe I'll find a better gnome that will build it based off of my idea or something. But basically, yeah, so sniper gnome basically is what I'm going to be going for. Yeah, when I was reading Paladins, I was like, oh man, it's so hard to not want to be a Paladin. And to be, I was really, really, really thinking about a Goliath Paladin. But I didn't do it because I think Goliaths are actually too big to be player characters. So if I were a Goliath, I'd have to be like a short Goliath. What is it? 7 foot. That might be pretty good. But then I'm like, well, why don't I just be a 7-foot human paladin? Cartographers? Oh, yeah. Yeah, it was hard when I was rolling up my monk. I'm like, what do I want my skill to be? And I don't remember what I picked, but I was looking at cartography too. Map making would be interesting. I don't remember what I picked. Oh, that's a pattern. You know, it's good. I was going to do a female character just so that we had one. I didn't realize yours was female. So that's good. I'm glad we got a female character. And fire, you said? Oh, you switched to earth. You change your mind more than I do, man. You're worse than me, and I'm pretty bad. Every day you got your mind changed up because I thought you were fire, right? You put F, so I thought you meant fire. But earth is cool. Yeah. You like to switch. And you know what? That's okay. As much as I like to know what everyone else is doing, in the end, it really doesn't matter. Just do what you want to do. There's a tiny chance I might go paladin. I'm just kind of rationalizing in my mind how I can enjoy the small stature. Because I always liked to melee. I mean, honestly, I love to have melee characters. Characters. Melee round. I can't say the word. Oh yeah, the F was for female. Okay, gotcha. So is your monk going to be follow the way of the elements? Have you decided yet? Yeah, I know. I think Mick and Connor know exactly who they want to be. I think it's you and I. We're like, oh man, we get one chance at this. What do we want to be? I was even thinking, is it so bad to have two monks? It'd be cool to have kind of like a martial arts rivalry going on. Because I was going to be Way of the Open Hand for sure. Yeah. I think it'll be fun playing the gnome because I can kind of be a little bit unpredictable, maybe a little bit of humor for the group, maybe a little bit of headache for the group. So yeah. So let me catch up here. So you haven't decided yet. I'm going to see how the role playing goes and choose. Okay, so you're going to pick your way later on. And then, because they've never played. Haha, yeah, because they've never played. It's easier for them. What do you mean there? I don't know what you're saying there. Because they're never played, meaning the female Genasi. And then it's easier for them to be what? Yeah, what do you mean there? You lost me there. I was talking too much. Okay. Because they've never played. I think Mix played. I think Connor either hasn't played or only played a little bit many years ago. I don't know if he's played or not. I think Mick has. And Bard, shoot, Bard's a great pick. I was reading up on Bard too. I'm like, wow, they're so interesting now. So it'll be a lot of fun. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, he said he was going to be a fighter. He surprised me with being a druid, being a dwarf. But, you know, dwarves are so cool. I love dwarves. It's kind of my favorite race. Barbarian, I like it. Yeah, it's hard for me to multi-class because, you know, you always look at, okay, if I do this and I give this up, do I want to? It's a tough call. Although if I'm going to multi-class with anything, rogue plus, sometimes I was thinking a rogue plus monk would be, you know, an awesome multi-class. I always want monk, sorcerer, but they don't mesh too well. But a rogue monk could. I think I'm actually going to stop drawing here for the night. You can actually identify this character. It's not an actual stream day. It's going to be, well, here's what I'm assuming. I don't know about you, but I made my characters on D&D Beyond, but there are character sheets inside Roll20, so I'm assuming part of our time is going to be transferring those characters over to the Roll20 sheets. Part of our time should be learning how to use the Roll20 interface, because it's brand new for me. I don't know squat about it. I was watching the tutorial, and I'm like, oh, there's a lot to it, so I'll have to get used to it. And even though we all technically have our characters, I bet it's going to be about just setting up the characters and making sure everything's copacetic. So yeah, it'll just be practice this first round. Unless we get everything done really quick, we might say, yeah, let's try it out. We'll start off with a bar fight. You know, you gotta have your bar fights. Yeah, I don't know how, I don't know how detailed the maps are gonna be, but when I played with my friends way back when, you know, when we first started off, we drew our maps as we went. You know, you go 10 feet, you draw a 10-foot square, you go 10 more feet. So we did it that way. But then we got bored of that, and so we just did everything out of imagination. So I had to keep track of everything. They tried to keep track of everything, but basically I had to know my whole dungeon mentally. And I had my own map, of course. It's not like I'm like out of my head, but I always had my map. And not always, sometimes we just wing it. But I'm looking forward to playing tabletop, and I hope he has maps. I hope we get to have our characters and move our characters around and use line of sight rules and all kinds of stuff. I'm looking forward to it. Really excited to play tabletop, virtual tabletop. So just for fun, if you don't do monk, what's your second choice? So we know my second choice. Well, we know my first three. I'll do the rogue, paladin, or monk. What are your top three picks? Second choice was cleric, and third was half-orc paladin. Cool, cool. Yeah, I think we're gonna miss not having a cleric or paladin healer, but we'll wing it. We'll make do. I think that'll make some of the adventures even more harrowing. I know Mick will be able to do some heals, but I can't imagine a bard being an especially strong healer. Yeah, I guess we'll find out how AP plays things. Because if it's like Dungeons and Dragons Online, yeah, you could go to the store and buy 100 potions if you wanted to. But if I were DMing, encumbrance would come into play. And there just wouldn't be that many potions sitting around. So sometimes you just don't have potions. So yeah, we'll see how much magic AP puts in his world. Alright, Bearded. See you tomorrow then. 5 o'clock, right? West Coast time, 5 o'clock? I'll see you then. I think I'm going to stop streaming too. Well, maybe I'll stick around for a little while. Yep, 5 o'clock. Okay, see you then. Hello, Cap Wolf. I like the little one-eyed stock beholder. That guy looks cool. You like it? You designed it. Or helped. We did it together. I like it. It's actually the first time I've seen it since you and I talked last. And it sort of surprised me. I'm like, you know what? That's actually a good looking badge. Oh, you're talking about the sub badge, yeah. You can actually zoom in on them? Or are you talking about just like staring at it long enough and seeing what it is? Yeah, I might take out the white lines and just let the facets, you mouse over the mouse. Let me see if it shows up bigger. Hover over it with mouse. No, not for me, but maybe it goes. Maybe that's a PC thing. Doesn't seem to. I can't zoom in. Are you on PC or Mac? You're on PC, right? That's okay. I know what the art looks like. But yeah, you guys gave me the idea. It was you and or... Oh, man. Gosh darn it. Not think of his name right now. Regulus. Thank you. Yes, it was Regulus. Yeah, we were doing that. So anyway, I might take the lines out and just use the facets of the gem. And that way the number shows up a little better too. But I love that idea of making it a dice. And I made them all 20-sided to start with. Because I got kind of lazy, to be honest. But I'm still happy with it. Still a great idea. Hosting you. Auto hosts. So you auto host me. Thank you very much. And then I got 19 people that are hosting me like right now. Could they possibly be hosting me right now? I gotta check this. Oops, that person just disappeared. Let's go check this. Open link in new window. Holy crap. I've got 19 people hosting me right now. Yes, this is your Mathiel. So just line work, just kind of working on them. But you can see where I'm at. Total fan art because it's the same pose as I'm finding on one of these posters. So totally fan art. I got the body lean wrong, but who cares? It's okay. Yeah, I like it. I like the badges. I like the little emote. Cool. Now I want new events so I can make new emotes. I'm gonna open up my emotes file. My wife cut my hair for me. She always cuts my hair. She's been cutting my hair for like 8 years. And so, yeah, I got all trimmed up today. Buzzed the sides, left more on top. This is the haircut I really like a lot. It almost rhymed. So Illustrator's taking the whole screen. Now I can move it. I can open over there for a while. All right. Yeah, she does good work. So I like it. She has good taste. I got to the point years ago where I'm like, you know what? Now this is actually what I wanted. So I told her, you know, or asked her to do it this way, but she actually got to this point the same time I did. So it's kind of, we both wanted it this way. Actually, as I think about it, I wanted it this way more like a year or two ago, year and a half ago, and she thought it was too extreme. But then every time she gives me a new cut, she makes it a little bit shorter, a little bit shorter, a little bit shorter. And then this time she goes, yeah, we should totally do it this way. I'm like, well, duh. That's what I've been wanting forever. So anyway, enough about my haircut. But yeah. Let's see if that file's open. You know, I know you see this cut all over the place now. I think she just needed to get used to it. It's almost like I wanted this, like I said, years ago. Like before Brad Pitt had a style like this in Fury, I had already wanted this style for a while. And I'm like, okay, now that he's got this style in Fury, it'll be more popular. And then it has been more popular. And mostly because of all, I think, the hipster guys. A lot of them have haircuts like this, which I always think look fantastic too. So she just got used to it. Which is good for me. I always like it when she likes it, because when she likes it, she likes me. So it's a win-win situation. You had a side cut too? Cool, man. Is that what you're doing now? Or are you sporting a different cut now? What's your current style? Shoulder length, wow. Big change. I've had long hair before, and I know for me, I love the long hair, but it's sort of, I probably didn't take care of it good enough, because it just was kind of wild. Are you the type to take care of your hair, stay on top of it? You don't have to. You must have good hair then. Yeah. easy to manage, I guess. Okay, by the time I'm done. Usually if I'm happy with him at the render stage, even at the rough stage, I'll be happy with him. Well, your ex-girlfriend secretly hated you for having such easy to comb hair. Yeah, no knots, no splits, all easy peasy. Yeah, they were jealous. Can you tell I'm avoiding doing the hands? To the last possible second. He's got some weird body laying, but that's all right. It's okay. Perspective's off. Not horrible, though. Something fishy was going on, meaning they secretly hated you. They got tired of going out in public and everyone was oohing and aahing at your hair and not theirs. Yeah, most of his pictures don't have the feet because he's got those robes. Well, I will do the hands. I'm just leaving them for last. But yeah, I can get away with not doing any feet this time around because he's got the long robes anyway. Plus, I want to be cropped in close enough so that body size he's at least about the same as the other pictures I've been doing. But I think I'm done drawing for the night. I can hang out and chat if you want to chat, but I mean, maybe I'll doodle a little bit, but just kind of chilling now. Yeah, me too. I'm going to get something more to drink, so I'll be right back too. Did I beat you back? Looks like I did. Nope. Okay. All right, let me close down some things here. I forgot to open up a couple panels. Un momento, por favor. Thank you. list, recent events. Okay. Hey, no worries, you know. I'm glad you stopped by and chatting with me. And I forget, you're 9 hours ahead. So what, did you stay up all night or you just got up early? So is it like 9:30 for you? I haven't streamed anything for... That's crazy, man. 4 hours sleep. Tuesday. Are you working today? But I was saying, I haven't streamed in like 4 days. And I actually forced myself. I go, screw it. I'm going to get on here. And I'm glad that I have. Once I get started on streaming, it goes by easy. It helps that I had a raid earlier tonight, too. You have to leave in an hour. Okay. Well, I should probably try to do some hands. So let's see if I can get something going here. Good thing is, I can just goof around till I get it. Actually, this hand should be easier. Oh no. Are you saying goodbye to your dog? It's horrible saying goodbye to your dogs. I've had to do that a couple times. Oh man, sorry to hear about that. What was the bad news? Yeah, dude, sorry to hear about that. I think you've told me this, but what kind of dog do you have? How old is she? One of the hardest, biggest cries I've had in my life was when my personal pet dog died, the one that grew up with me as a kid. Oof, that was a rough day. Flat-coated retriever, okay. Yeah, I won't pretend that it won't hurt. It's going to be horrible. So, how... I know she's got the tumor, of course, but how is she feeling right now? Like, she's still moving around okay? Or does it look like the tumor is causing her problems? And the reason why I'm bringing it up is like, dude, just do everything you can with your dog, man. Everything you possibly can. Spend as much time as possible. Not in pain, okay. At least there's that. Oh, that's good. Glad to hear that. Yeah, I don't even have words of console. It's just, it's not fun. Not that it's ever fun, but yeah. My dog had leukemia, so I don't remember how long it took her to go downhill, but I know she was weak for a while. And even though she's very sick, when she finally passed away, it still surprised me. It still caught me off guard. But I also think I was young and ignorant, didn't take it serious enough. Self-centered, being young, but yeah, she was an awesome dog. I mean, everyone loves their dog. But yeah, she was pretty special. That was a long time ago. But thank you. And if you're like me, you're always in denial. I always thought that she was still going to make it, even though she was sick. You know, one more day. Yeah, two ways of looking at it, right? I think you're truthful right there, is that you're always hoping that they'll keep lasting for you. And my dog wasn't in pain, according to the vet. She started to slow down a lot of walking and didn't want to walk anymore, but I think that's because she was weak, not in pain. So, anyway, I hope your dog sticks around as long as possible. In good health, of course. Be waiting for you. Isn't that one of the nice thoughts about believing in heaven? That there's always a bright future waiting for you. Neither do I. But by the time I find out I'm wrong, it's gonna be too late. I'll be lucky if I get stuck in purgatory. I could go to purgatory if I could draw. Does anyone deserve purgatory? I'm not big in religion, but purgatory is just for folks who didn't believe but weren't evil, right? Limbo? Purgatory and limbo are the same thing? I always think that too. There's a heaven, why not? Why not be welcoming to everyone? Why is it a members only club? forget. A little bit of proof could go a long way. You lose me a little bit on that first sentence. I get believing in God would be easier if, got that much. Believing in humans would be, if believing in humans would be. So if we could believe in the goodness of the human race, then it would be easier to believe in God. Is that what you're saying? Which I agree with. Yeah, I think it's pretty clear religion is all about manipulation. Thank you. save this all night. Yep. Alright, I'll have to fix his hand later. I'm gonna leave it as it is. Yeah, I swiped it. And it's not as good as the original, but that's okay. It's fan art, so I'm happy with it. I think he looks pretty cool. I'm pretty happy with him. I'm glad you like it too. Glad you like the pose. I think he'll be tough for me to color because he's all really dark patterns, really dark colors. Oh, he actually has wings. Like they use purple as his armor color, so I'll be working some purples in. Not all of them. Sometimes his armor looks a deep blue. Hey, no problem, Cap. I'm glad you stuck around, and you know, I hope everything. You know, it's kind of tough to say. You want to say I hope everything works out, but spend some time with your pups, man. At least you have the chance of spending, you know, time with them before they go or before she goes. So, and if she's there to have fun, go have a bunch of fun. Hey, you and me, we both blabber. No problem. It's all good. Yeah, I think I'm going to close down and stop streaming for the night anyway. I got to get up in the morning. So, thanks for coming by, Cap. And everyone else who's still out there, thanks for coming by and chilling out with me tonight. I will probably be on tomorrow night. I'm trying to make it more consistent. So, but I'm always on late at night. Well, late for me. Is your dog's name Doggo? That's a cool name. All right, Cap, I'll let you go. Take off, buddy. Ha 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 ha. Doggo. Doggo's a cool name, though. Toffee, yeah. That's a good name, too. All right, bye-bye. I'll start closing down now, too. Good night, everyone.